place where it's crafting?
No, not yet.
The heat is on!
Well, tell them I'm loaded and looking for action. I require 5,000 cents.
5,000 bucks?
Where do you acquire it?
I collected the reward of my father.
Maybe better find a place. Sounds like the hero's high place.
Why, Lieutenant Brennigan! Hey, Ben, it's Lieutenant Brennigan of the New York Police Department.
A pleasure.
Have you guys seen Nathan Detroit?
Which Nathan Detroit is it?
I mean the Nathan Detroit who's been running a floating craft game around here. You can tell him from me. I know right now he's running around trying to find a spot.
Hi, Nathan.
No, I'm having terrible trouble. Everyone's scared on how that lousy plan.
Nothing wrong, Mr. Detroit?
Oh, no, Lieutenant. I don't mean anything we're talking about you. There are other lousy brands.
Detroit, I imagine you're having some trouble finding a place for your craft game.
Well, the heat is on, as you must know, and the fact that you have to live on your salary.
Nate, did you find a place for your game?
I was just over in the Biltmore Garage. Joey says he might take a chance and let me use the place. I think I'm $1,000.
$1,000?
In cash.
Where are you going to get it from?
Okay. So I have a theory. Here it is. We're going and get Sky Masterson, who's the highest player of all. You.
Why don't you borrow $1,000 from Sky?
Not Sky. That kind of money ain't that money. It's that kind of money ain't money. It's betting money.
Why do you bet Sky?
Why don't you
make a crazy bet, Sky? Thank you.
what did you say to him?
I told him. I said, I'll give you whatever I want. Nathan, have me an oyster.
A present for me?
I hope you like it.
A belt.
Bring the card.
Sugar is sweet, and so is jelly. So put this belt around your belly. That's so sweet. Okay. About your present, I didn't get one. I'm sorry.
No. I kind of love it when you forget to give me presents. It makes me feel like we're married.
Look, honey, don't worry. One of these days I'll give you money, and you'll have more of me than of me.
Nathan, darling, I mean, you tell anything, just so long as you don't start running the crap game again.
The crap game? What an absurd thought.
Yesterday, Mindy sold 1,200 cheesecake and 1,500 sprudel.
More sugar than cheesecake? That's great.
Nathan, what is this?
Nothing, honey. Look, Adelaide, I'm expecting to come up, and I know you're hungry.
Nathan, are you trying to get rid of me?
No, I just don't want your sandwich to get soggy.
Nathan, you old promoter, you!
Well, how are you, Scott? I've been in town long.
Flying to Havana tomorrow.
Havana?
A lot of action down there. Wanna come with me?
Nah, I have things to do. Tell me, wanna run to me and get a piece of cheesecake or soup or something?
Nah, I think I'll go with the lady folks.
But you will admit that Mindy has the greatest cheesecake in the country.
I'm quite partial to Mindy's cheesecake.
But wait, and yet there are some people who like Mindy's soup. How much do you want to bet that yesterday Mindy sold more soup than cheesecake?
I don't know, I've never really given it much thought. But if everyone is like I am, I say she sells more cheesecake than strudel.
For how much?
What?
I will bet you $1,000 that yesterday Mindy sold more strudel than cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story. When I was a young man just about to go into the world, my father told me a very valuable thing. Son, the old guy says to me, sometimes in your travels, a guy will come up to you with a brand new deck of cards and offer to bet you that he can make a jack of spades jump out and squirt cider in your ear. Now, do not bet this man, for I assure you are standing there, you will end up with an ear full of cider. Now, I do not claim that you have been clocking Mindy's cheesecake.
You don't think that.
But if you want a little action, I will bet the same $1,000 that you do not know the color of your necktie. Well?
No bet. Green. What a crazy color.
She says for you to pick her up at the hot box.
and the food is delicious. Please go away.
Somewhere in this world, there might be a guy who appeals to the sergeant. I wonder what that guy would be like.
I'm not going to do that.
You're always reading books. You're becoming a regular bookie.
Thank you, darling. This is very interesting. The doctor gave it to me. I went to him about my cold.
How is your cold?
It's the same. So the doctor asked me how long I had had it, and I told him a long time. And so he said to read this book, because he said it might be due to psychology.
You haven't got that, have you?
Nathan, this is a psychology that tells you why good over certain kinds of things. What do you think I got here?
Sadly,
promise longer.
So sue me.
Troy, if you do not have no game to place for your crap game, tell us and we will seek elsewhere for entertainment.
I'm taking it easy, Harris.
I would like you to meet Big Julie from Chicago. I came here to shoot crap. Let's shoot crap. Excuse me, Troy. There is no place for this crap game. Big Julie will be considerably displeased, and Big Julie does not like to be displeased.
These are delicious.
not what I meant.
Sky, you said it yourself. It's no good.
It's no good. What kind of doll are you anyway?
I'm a mission doll.
I'm shooting 2,000. And Detroit, I'm gonna go.
shooting crap.
It'll only be one thing. It has to do with Miss Sarah Brown's mission.
Say, who is this guy?
It's the fellow I was telling you who took the mission down to Havana.
Look, you're slowing up the action around here.
If you want some action, would you like to make a small wager on a little proposition?
What's the proposition?
Am I right handed or my left hand?
How would I know a thing like that?
I'll give you a clue. Look, you guys, tonight in Miss Sarah Brown's mission, at 409 West 49th Street, they're holding a midnight prayer meeting. I promised them I would deliver some sinners. And when it comes to sin, you guys are high up among the gay cards. I guarantee you, the mission smells cleaner than down here. And it probably wouldn't hurt for you guys to learn something to get in the four of the hard way. Well, I try. See you around, Nathan.
Okay, Sky, about that Havana business, I regret that I temporarily do not have a 1,000 to pay
you. You don't have to pay me. You won.
But I thought you could go with that.
You got wrong.
Okay, Big Julian, get up. I now have enough money to roll you, but with my dice.
Nothing doing. With your dice, you cannot make a pass to save the soul.
What'd you say?
I said with them dice, you cannot make a pass to save the soul.
Well, I bet I can make a pass to save his, and his, and his and yours. I will bet each of you $1,000 against your souls. $1,000 for a marker for your souls. If I win, you guys all show up for the mission tonight. Okay? One meeting. You too, Nathan. $1,000 against your soul.
Me? I don't even know if I got one.
You got one somewhere. Give me this. Hey, give me your room. I got a little more than Joe right now. They call you Lady Luck, but there is a room for doubt. At times, you can very young lady like way of running out. Everybody here? Where's Nathan Detroit?
Present.
Miss Sarah, here you are. 1 dozen or less assorted sinners. Sorry we didn't have time to clean them up.
Sit down,
all of you. And this is a mission, not Rosalind. So I suggest that you do not indulge in any unpleasantness. Since I have to appoint Westerners tonight, I appoint Nathan Detroit Major Domo in my court. If you guys do not act according to Hoyle, you will have to be personally to Sky Masterson.
What a truly remarkable young man.
So remember that, you guys. Brother Abernathy, your guest.
I commend your honor tonight. The meeting will be conducted by the head of our organization, General Kirk.
It's wonderful to see our mission graced by the presence of so many people. Now, who would like to get the ball rolling by giving testimony?
Benny, give testimony.
I am most humbly.
Humbly. I know it is difficult, but let one of you give testimony to the sinner of his heart. Anyone?
Harry?
Oh, no.
Harry the horse!
Like you, Scott is rolling for our souls.
I beg your pardon?
Scott Masterson, you bet us $1,000 against our souls. That's what we're here to give.
I don't think I understand.
I do, General. He means the only reason they're here is because Mr. Masterson won them in a dice game.